Images are essential to modern web design, enhancing visual appeal, conveying information, and improving user experience. They make a website more engaging, memorable, and effective. However, broken images can disrupt the content flow and leave a negative impression on visitors. Whether caused by incorrect file paths, server errors, or network issues, it's crucial to handle these errors gracefully and maintain a seamless experience. In this video, we will explore different ways to style broken images and implement fallback options. But first, hit the subscribe button and ring the notification bell to stay updated on our front-end development tips and tricks. Let's begin. Okay, let's quickly go through the demo page we are working with today. It resembles a typical blog layout featuring a list of posts. Each post includes a title, a thumbnail, a summary, and a link to explore further. In the HTML, we have the page titles and then use an article element to define the overall layout of each blog post. These articles are further divided into two sections: the post title and the post summary, which contains the thumbnail and other relevant content. Moving on to the style sheet, aside from the foundational styles, I have applied the necessary CSS to make our content look good. First, there are CSS rules for the post title and the image. After that, a media query block is included to ensure the layout adapts seamlessly to different screen sizes, followed by some standard styling for the view more links to maintain a consistent look and feel. And this is what our blog page looks like. As you can see, it adapts gracefully to different screen sizes, ensuring a better user experience. We've also optimized the links using the Focus Visible pseudo class to provide clear visual feedback for keyboard users. Now suppose, for some reason, our images fail to load. This could be due to incorrect file paths, network issues, server errors, or other factors. When this happens, browsers typically display a default icon with alternative text, if provided. However, this can disrupt the visual flow of the content and even cause layout issues, negatively impacting the user experience. While CSS doesn't have a built-in mechanism to detect broken images, we can utilize the onerror event of the image tag. This allows us to trigger a CSS class change or apply styles directly when an image fails to load. Technically, the error event is triggered on an element when a resource fails to load or cannot be used. In the context of images, this event is fired when an image can't be loaded. A simple approach is to set an onerror event handler and hide broken images entirely. We do this by adding inline styles that set the display property to none. This effectively removes the problematic image from the front end and the accessibility tree. While this approach works in many situations, we don't have to settle for simply hiding broken images. There are other solutions that allow us to style them more gracefully and keep the page layout intact. We can employ a pseudo-element to create a fallback option for failed images. Typically, before and after pseudo-elements won't work on images, but these elements can appear when an image fails to load. In this case, we are using the before pseudo-element to create a placeholder for the missing image. By positioning it absolutely with the inset property set to 0, we ensure it covers the entire image block. We have also applied additional styling to create a visually appealing and informative placeholder. The key to this approach is the content property. And by using the attribute CSS function, we can retrieve the value of the alt attribute from the image and concatenate it with the string not found, creating a descriptive message for users. To ensure the pseudo element is positioned correctly relative to its parent, the parent element's position should be set to relative. While this approach looks good, it's important to note that there are some compatibility issues. This method may not work flawlessly in all browsers, particularly Safari, which doesn't support pseudo elements directly on images. Now let's explore another solution that enjoys broader browser compatibility. We will once again utilize the onerror event handler, but this time, we will replace the failed image with a fallback image. What we are doing is attaching an onerror event handler to the image, and when an error occurs, we are replacing the image's source attribute with the URL of a predefined fallback image, and then adding the broken image CSS class to the image tag. The first statement, where we set onerror to null, prevents the browser from falling into an infinite loop. If, for any reason, the newly assigned fallback image is also broken, this line ensures that the browser doesn't repeatedly trigger the error event. Let's take this solution a step further. Instead of adding these statements to every image, we can create a callback function that can be applied to any image on the page. A simple way is to add a script tag in the head section and create a function that accepts an image element as its argument. Within this function, we disable the onerror event to prevent infinite loops, update the source attribute with the fallback image URL, add a new CSS class, and even modify the alt attribute to indicate that the original image is unavailable. The reason I have added this script to the head section is that it performs the critical function of replacing bad images with updated info, and it should be ready to handle image errors as soon as the images begin to load. There are other ways to achieve the desired results and keep the script at the bottom of the page or in an external file, but for the sake of this tutorial, we're keeping things simple. The next step is to call the function whenever an error event is triggered. Finally, we can style the newly added CSS class to align with our project guidelines. This solution is guaranteed to work consistently across browsers. Handling broken images is essential for maintaining a positive user experience. By styling broken images and providing fallback options, we can ensure that users can still access relevant information, even when images fail to load. We've explored various approaches to address broken images, including hiding them, leveraging JavaScript for dynamic handling, and incorporating image placeholders. Choose the method that best suits your needs to create a more robust and user-friendly website. And that's a wrap on styling broken images. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more front-end development tips and tricks. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.